Well, better late than never. So, thank you, allergies and sinus headaches. Sarcasm! Howdy, hey there, and hello. I'm Montez McCrary, the PractitioNERD, and welcome to the February 2015 episode of reWIRED, bringing you my favorite nerdy geeky stories of the month about architecture, technology, video games, and professional wrestling from thepractitionnerd.com. Anyways, stories. A nonprofit organization in Madison, Wisconsin has created a small world for the area's homeless. Right now, there's an estimated 3,370 homeless people and rising in the area. But thanks to the efforts of Occupy Madison, those numbers will be dropping very soon. The village contains 9 tiny homes, day resource centers, and access to restrooms, showers, laundry, with some future plans including a community garden, a tree orchard, and chickens in the spring. And it gives the area's homeless a safe and warm place to sleep, reports Revolution News. The tiny homes, all made from reclaimed or recycled materials, are 98 square feet and include a bed, kitchen, bathroom storage, and a propane heat. Now the homes cost an estimated $3,000 just to build, all of which came from donations. Other architecture stories that I covered on the site this past month include a house in Brazil with sliding pergolas, the 10 Frank Lloyd Wright buildings that are to be designated UNESCO World Heritage Sites, and 2 college students build a tiny house for only $500, which is still probably cheaper than living in the dorms at most major universities. During Annie Easley's 34-year career, she worked on and contributed to technologies and software that led to hybrid vehicles and great strides in spacecraft and exploration. And she did all of this as one of the first few African Americans in her field. Despite racial tensions and segregation, Easley rose above, making calculations and computations for engineers at NACA, becoming a math technician at NASA, and as the technology evolved, Easley's education did as well. She learned computer programming to write code in the SOAP and Fortran languages, and she used those skills to develop the Centaur software for numerous communication and weather satellites and exploratory spacecrafts for NASA. Other technology stories I covered on the site this past month include a rub-on tattoo for diabetics that could replace finger pricking, how to convert some AA batteries into a single C battery with some cardboard strips, and the FCC laying the smackdown on ISPs regarding what true broadband is. And wow, pro net neutrality has had a great February, huh? But don't rest on your laurels just yet. There's still a lot of work to be done. The concept of using cartridges in gaming has become somewhat of a distant memory now, except for dedicated handhelds like the 3DS and Vita, and if you're a retro game collector like myself. But back in the day, you know, cartridges were essentially the only way to get video games playing onto a television set. Inserting and removing socketed electronic assemblies have been an activity reserved for trained technicians, engineers, and military personnel at the time. So Fairchild Semiconductors knew that putting a sensitive circuit board into the hands of the average consumer meant that the board needed a protective shell of some kind, you know, to keep the customers from stepping on the board and destroying it, or dropping it in the toilet or in the sink, or leaving it outside to the elements. Sometimes we kind of have to protect ourselves. Some other gaming stories I've covered on the site this past month include Scarface being turned into an NES game, an Eiffel 65 song about the original PlayStation, and a fan remake of Resident Evil 2 and Unreal Engine 3, since Capcom likes to ignore remaking that game as opposed to the first one. But hey, I'm not bitter. Not one bit. The feud between John Cena and Rusev is looking to be more than just some one-dimensional rehash of some unwarranted patriotism and name-calling a la, the near any fictional story that was written during the Cold War. Kind of like Rocky IV. Speaking of, thankfully some awesome individual decided to throw together a bunch of Cena and Rusev footage and redo the popular No Easy Way Out montage from Rocky IV, the most American movie ever, with Zack Ryder as Apollo Creed, the golden moment of seeing John Cena badly edited into the front seat of a car going down the tunnel. Plus, the whole thing is set to what is quite possibly the greatest song ever recorded for a sports movie montage. Other pro wrestling stories I've covered on the site this past month include Brad Maddox's hilarious YouTube series, an awesome triple threat match from Anarchy Championship Wrestling, and proof that Vince McMahon is still a scary, scary man, according to his recent muscle and fitness cover picture. Honestly, even at his age, I don't want to make him angry. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. Please like, love, share the video, add it to your favorites. Subscribe to the Practitioner channels on Blip, Daily Motion, and YouTube. And you can follow me on all the social networks. Check out thepractitioner.com for all the nerdy geekery on architecture, technology, video games, professional wrestling, and other randomness. And if you have an opinion or something you'd like to share and or add, leave a comment below this video and on thepractitioner.com. You can support The Practitioner by going to thepractitioner.com and or by clicking those Amazon US, Amazon Canada, ThinkGeek, and other affiliate links below to shop at those places and support this channel and the website. So I'll see you guys next time, and remember to stay true to yourselves, stay blessed, and stay nerdy.